Hello, and welcome to 5 minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we'll talk about optimizing with the Postgres deterministic query planner. This is a blog post by the engineering team at AHA, and they're talking about three different ways of how they've tuned the planner, and they also show a specific case where they've improved query performance up to 20,000%. Pretty bold claim. We'll talk more about that in a second. First of all, they mention setting the cost for page access. Planner looks at different tables in a query, and it looks at doing a full table scan or index scan and the different options that are available. The planner uses two important parameters to cost its disk access. It uses the random page cost when it expects to make a random read. For example, in an index, all the pages, they're all over the place, versus a sequential scan where it has to load a big portion of the table, and sequential page cost is what comes into play. Pages in Postgres are usually 8 kilobytes. That means each of these values here for these cost settings talks about fetching 8 kilobytes worth of data. The random page cost by default is 4, and sequential page cost is 1. The default costs a random page access 40 times slower than a sequential scan, but it does assume that 90% of the pages are already cached in memory, which is why random page cost is not 40, random page cost is 4, because it assumes that 90% cache rate. But it's assuming that this is a spinning metal storage device, a good old hard disk, a typical NVMe drive on a cloud provider these days, the number is probably closer to 5 to 10x. Random page access is still more expensive, but it's not as expensive as it was on older drives. The way that they've updated the random page cost setting, they didn't just mess around with the parameters until the plan looked good. They actually tried to reason about it. They said, we think it's 5 to 10x slower, let's err on the 5 times. And then they're assuming a higher cache hit ratio of 99%. And so that's why they've set the random page cost parameter to 1.05. In their particular case, this did give them a drastic improvement on their query performance. The second thing that they discovered, using statistics when columns have dependencies between each other. We give the example here of this features table, and they are querying the account ID, the product ID, and the initiative ID columns. By default, what Postgres will do is it will assume that these are independent columns. They don't have a relation to another. There might be some overlap, but none of them is contained by the other. In their particular case, their data looks more like this, where all the initiative ID 3 rows also had account ID 1. And most of these rows also had product ID 2. If you were to filter just by initiative ID 3, you would get very high selectivity, a good indicator that you would want an index on initiative ID. When Postgres would see multiple of these indexes, Postgres doesn't know that. Postgres might choose the wrong index or might combine multiple indexes unnecessarily. What they're suggesting is you use the create statistics command and the dependency statistics type, and then you tell Postgres to collect additional statistics on the columns that are dependent on another. Then they run analyze to have Postgres collect the new statistics. What the planner will know is that when two of these columns are involved in a query, they'll be able to estimate much more accurately how much each of those is adjusting the selectivity of the query. This was the pathological case where a query was taking 20 seconds, and then with these statistics, they were able to reduce that down to 1 millisecond. The last thing that they mention here, when Postgres joins a lot of tables, there's logic in Postgres that switches how it behaves in terms of the planning process. Once you exceed a certain number of tables, it becomes more expensive to find the optimal join order. By default, Postgres will have a deterministic planning algorithm, but if there are too many tables involved, Postgres actually switches to a genetic algorithm to try to find the optimal join order. You might think genetic algorithm sounds fancy, you know, is good to have, but the trade-offs there are different. Like, it's not going to give you the best results in many cases. If you can afford it, deterministic planning is probably better. What they ended up doing is raising this GEQO threshold to have the genetic algorithm trigger less often. Also, they increased the GEQO effort, which meant that the genetic algorithm tried more generations. The other thing that you can tune in terms of handling larger number of tables better is the join collapse and the from collapse limit settings. If you have a lot of tables involved and you do want to pay the extra cost at planning time, it may make sense to raise this limit. Overall, they have a saying here, instead of using tricks, give Postgres better data, tell Postgres how your data looks like, give it better statistics. That's how you tune a planner. If you just used hints, for example, you're just overriding what Postgres is doing versus using its ability to adapt based on how your data might change. This was 5 minutes of Postgres. Thank you so much for listening. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episodes, and talk to you next week.